just might be the dirtiest, drunkest, drug-addled rockers who ever cleaned up their act. But there's plenty of hardcore grime left behind. Tommy. Nick. Nikki. And Vince are back. Motley Crue is here, and Lewis Black. Right now, on Larry King Live.
Hey, rockers are rejoicing. Motley Crue has a new CD, Saints of Los Angeles. It's their first studio album of new material by the group's original lineup in a decade. Their tour, Crue Fest, kicks off on July 1st. Here they are, my pals. Yes, they are my pals. Motley Crue, Tommy Lee, you know him. Vince Neil, Nikki Sixx, and Mick Mars. Welcome, guys.
I'm over here.
What are you doing over there? You got the bad seat.
I always get the bad seat. You know.
What brought this all back together, Mick?
Greed.
that's an honest answer, right? Nikki, what did it? Why is Motley Crue again?
Well, you know, to be honest, we went out, what, 2 years ago?
Yeah, 2005 and 2006.
We toured for almost two years.
Yeah.
And we had not been together for a while as the original lineup.
I know.
But we never broke up after that. I mean, we didn't break up. But what we had
said we did.
But and then people always say that, and they might be half right.
But you didn't have an album.
That's what we didn't have.
That's right.
We haven't made a record together, official full length record, in 9-10 years.
Yeah.
So what brought about Saints of Los Angeles, Tommy?
What brought about?
Yeah, I mean,
I don't know. You know, like Nikki said, we haven't made a record in a while, and we've done a couple of new tracks here and there on greatest hits, you know, packages, but it's time for us to like make a full-on album.
Mick, anything behind the title?
The Saints of Los Angeles is the album is loosely based on The Dirt, the book that we have out. Loosely based, I believe that Saints of Los Angeles is like kind of like you know, like our record signing, and we signed our lives away. So, you know, that kind of a thing, you know. So it's all good, you know. So
how
it's based on the thing.
How did the tattooing start?
He did it.
Who did it?
I did it.
He did it.
Who was first?
Who was first?
I don't know who was first.
I'm not sure. But we all pretty much right around the same time. Mm-hmm. Very early, like the first record, did we start getting tattooed? Tommy wasn't even old enough to get a tattoo.
No.
Yeah. And the first record. Yeah. Not that stopped us from doing anything.
Childhood, right? I mean, you know each other.
Yeah, me and Tommy went to high school together, and I slept in his van outside of his parents' house. And they actually, you know, they didn't know who the guy was sleeping outside there in their son's car. So they actually invited me in, and I slept on the floor next to Tommy's bed for a long time.
Well, who said, let's get tattooed?
I can't remember how that started, but we were always, like, into tattoos and into anything that was rebellious. And I think in the beginning, you know, for me personally, tattoos were like, what's going on? Not my first one. My first one was that rose right there.
That's right.
And that was it. And it was it. We all went.
Tommy's wearing suspenders tonight.
Yeah, Larry, I'm rocking these just for you, Peaches.
How about that? I hung out with Motley Crue at a rehearsal a few days ago in Los Angeles. We'll be watching what went on throughout the show. Watch some of it now.
Uh-oh. Here we go.
Rocket, baby. Here we are.
Six, though.
Why do you still need... I'm serious.
Why do we still need so many amps?
Why do you still need to rehearse?
Oh, I mean, new songs.
Oh.
New album,
yeah. New record.
You think you'd have it down by now?
Yeah.
Are you going to play a little?
I was thinking that the last time I saw you,
you had a little drum
session on your desk.
Yeah. Right. Oh, yeah.
But I was thinking now that we're here with the real deal.
Yeah, let's.
Look at how big that drum set is, too.
Drums 101.
Uh-oh, watch out. Put your foot on that pedal.
Yeah.
So this guy counts, he's your timekeeper. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4.
So you gotta go 1, 2.
Oh, we got some bass.
All right.
Oh yeah, he's doing tricks already. This is amazing. Yeah, Larry. Woo-hoo.
A star is born.
That was a lot of fun.
That's awesome.
I liked when you were playing the guitar, though.
Now, that comes in a while.
Does it?
I think I wrote a song there. Yeah. Anyway, are your tunes hummable?
Oh, yeah.
Can people leave a concert and sing a Motley Crue song?
That's kind of one of the things that we always, you know, pride ourselves on, you know. You got to have those melodies that... You know, you leave the concert going, you know, singing girls, 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 or Dr. Feelgood, or Don't Go Away Mad, or even with the new stuff. You know, it's always been something that we, you know, always.
So
make
not
sure
just,
that's
it's not just
important.
Sounds and.
It's not just we're not.
Because hard rock is associated with.
I mean, hard rock is more melodic, like the Rolling Stones and Aerosmith and AC/DC. And you start getting into heavy metal, and it starts to lose some of that. People do think we're heavy metal. I don't really think we are.
No, we're more pop.
What would you
call
yourself?
I mean,
just a rock and roll band.
Rock and roll band.
Yeah. Rock and roll.
We'll come back with the rock and roll band, Motley Crue. They're starting a big tour.
Yeah.
Tommy and Pam Anderson. Hey, we got to ask.
Easy.
And I will right after the break.
Easy.